Hi, I'm Sasha, Community Engagement Coordinator with Galveston Bay Foundation, here to share this year's new Galveston Bay report card grades. If you haven't seen our short video about how this citizen-driven report is created each year in partnership with the Houston Advanced Research Center, check it out here. Hopefully, you've explored the Galveston Bay report card online. If so, you may have noticed some things have changed this year, so let's check them out.
We have good news in the habitat category. This year, we have updated wetland data, and we received information that shows potential oyster reef habitat in the bay. There's still more to learn, but we're excited for this news. Remember that you can take part in habitat restoration and conservation by volunteering with Galveston Bay Foundation. Learn more here.
We also had good news in the water quality category. That grade improved from a B to an A, due to the bay receiving an A for phosphorus this time. And the wildlife category showed an improvement in the shellfish grade thanks to blue crab populations stabilizing and improvements in the brown shrimp populations. The coastal grade change did not change overall, but relative sea level rise continues to be a concern and is impacting our area. Check out the July cover story on our website.
Unfortunately, in the human health category, we saw a change in the recreation safety grade from an A to a B. This was due to higher bacteria levels at two beach sites. The biggest change from last year was the pollution events and sources grade. Unfortunately, a large oil spill of almost 600,000 gallons occurred in May of 2019 in Galveston Bay. This brought the oil spill volume grade down from an A to an F. This category also includes legacy pollutants in the Houston Ship Channel, as well as litter and trash. We don't have full data on litter and trash yet, but we're working on it. What's new this year is the addition of fishing line trash sightings in the watershed on our trash map. To help reduce fishing waste, we have added the link to fishing line recycling tube locations in our What You Can Do tool. This tool offers customized suggestions and resources for ways people can help the bay, based on their interests and the amount of time they have.
Speaking of what you can do, pollution is something everyone can help prevent and clean up, especially litter, trash, and pet waste. So we have a mission for you to help us protect Galveston Bay. This year, we are launching Mission Pollution Prevention. In this new section of our website, you'll find resources for how to tackle pollution, cover stories with tips and tricks to reduce trash, prevent litter, and recycle properly. Galveston Bay is an important part of the Houston-Galveston area, and it needs your help to stay healthy, so we can all enjoy it for generations to come. Join our mission so together we can protect our backyard bay.